Children, welcome to the geography class, and here we are covering agriculture, and this will be the last lecture of the chapter, and here we are covering impact of globalization on agriculture. In the impact of globalization in agriculture, there are the various points on which we have to focus, and this is the first point, that is the colonization. Colonization, it means the British rule. At the time of the British rule, the condition of India was not that much good, because they were pressurizing the people to cultivate the indigo plantation. As a result, the land loses its fertility. Because why the indigo they are pressurizing? Because it was at that time mainly crop which is required by the industries of England. Then in the colonization, if you will see the Manchester, which is famous for the cotton textile, and Liverpool also. So they have established only because of the India. India is having a very good quality of cotton, and that was exported from the time of Britishers to the Britain, and they have established their own industries over there, and that is now at present we can say it is the renowned one, that is the Manchester. As we can say, the Manchester of India is the Ahmedabad. So it means the cotton textile, though this area doesn't have the production of the cotton, but then also they have established the such a large industry. Then we have the example of the Champaran movement, which is initiated by Gandhiji in 1917. So why he did? Because at that time the farmers, they were pressurized by the Britishers to cultivate indigo, and as we know that indigo cultivation reduces the fertility of the soil, though it required for the cultivation a very good of fertile soil, but as we used to do frequently this crop, then the land loses its fertility. So that is also the bad effect on the Indian land. So this will also become one of the reason of the land degradation at that time. After that, there were the new challenges which were faced by the India after 1947. After 1947, it was a time period when India got independence. So, just after the independence, as we know that there were various changes had done by the Britishers. So, definitely there will be the impact of that. So, due to the indigo plantation, indigo cultivation, the soil became barren. The land became barren. As a result, the India, after the independence, India was not capable to fulfill the needs of the Indian people itself. So at that time, in the starting, we used to import the grains just to fulfill the needs of the citizen. After that, it realized that something should be there to so that India can be self-dependent. So green revolution was introduced. In this, the HYB seeds, fertilizers, pesticides were used by the people, by the farmers. But in this, there is a negative role of green revolution was also there. Though it has contributed a lot, it was having the positive result. And only because of this green revolution, the India became self-dependent. But then also, whenever the amount of the pesticides or fertilizers were used in the land area, every next dose, that the amount should be increased. Then only the production can get the proper production in this way. So as the amount increases, then definitely the layer of the soil started the blockage, because it has some pores. So these pores, due to this fertilizer and pesticide, they used to block, and gradually the soil layer wise loses its fertility. So this would be a negative impact on the green Indian revision. Then after that there is a new revision by the genetic engineers. They have engineering. They have introduced the gene revision. That is basically for the high varieties of the seeds. In this, the high variety of the hybrid variety of the seeds will be introduced by the scientists, and this can also increase the production of the country. Then we have the organic farming. So above all, whatever that we have done, whether we are talking about the green revolution or we are talking about the gene revolution, so they are not impacting good on the land. But here is the organic farming, which doesn't have any negative impact on the environment. So because in this we are not using the fertilizer and pesticides, which is produced in the factories by using the chemicals, so it will not be harmful for the environment. So it is the safe, or we can say don't have any negative impact on environment. Fine. Then we have the Indian farmers. The government is doing lot of for the betterment of the Indian agriculture, but then also the economists, they used to say that the Indian farmers, they are having the dark future. So for converting this dark future into the bright future, what we can do? We can use the high value crops, HVC. That is high value crops like fruits, flowers, medicinal herbs, biodiesel crops like zectrofa or jojoba. So these are the examples of the high value of crops. So what is the specialty of these crops? These require less irrigation as compared to wheat, rice or sugarcane, and they are having a very good demand in the international market also. So because if the farmer, they used to grow these crops along with that, with the wheat, rice, and the usually they used to grow, so then the dark future can be converted into the bright future. So here it is important, but Indian farmers are not that much literate, so they are not aware about the high value crops. But the government should make the policy so that they came to know about the high value crops and they go for this. Fine. Now here we are completing with this chapter. Thank you.